Yes, Bobby Jindal, Louisiana governor, is still running for president, even though he's currently polling a little under 2%. But fear not, he, if elected president, has a plan to deal with ISIS. Watch.
We need to enforce that no-fly. We need to create a no-fly zone working with our Turkish and other allies. Our Sunni allies want to do more, but they're not going to go after ISIS if that merely leaves Assad in power. They don't want Assad in power.
Let's talk about a no-fly zone. ISIS doesn't have aircraft. So what would that no-fly zone really accomplish? When is it really worked?
Well, it accomplishes a couple of things. It accomplishes a couple of things, Martha. One, it helps to stabilize the region so you don't have all these refugees flooding into Europe and trying to leave the country. Secondly, it gives us space for moderates, for Kurds and others to group and to plan attacks against ISIS, against Assad. Third, it keeps Russia from bombing our allies, the folks that we're working with. It also shows our Sunni allies in the region that we're serious about winning this. So these are radical Islamic terrorists that are burning people alive, crucifying, killing Christians and other religious minorities. We can't negotiate with them. We got to hunt them down and kill them before they attack us here.
Okay, first of all, obviously Bobby Jindal has no clue what ISIS actually is. Okay, they don't have military bases. They don't even have buildings or compounds where they go and sit and strategize. This is a disorganized group of terrorists. They don't know what they're doing. They don't know how they're going to do it. They just know that they're going to go somewhere and screw things up. But more importantly, not only does Jindal not understand how ISIS and terrorism works, he doesn't understand how the military works. He has no idea what we've been doing in the Middle East to fight off these extremists. Absolutely pathetic for somebody that thinks he's qualified to run the free world. If you notice in the last part of that clip where he talks about the fact that we've got to stop them over there or they're going to come over here and start killing us, that is exactly what George W. Bush said when he invaded Iraq. Let's go kill them over there before they kill us over here. And more importantly, though, this whole clip is exactly what the Republican Party is all about. This is all they were able to talk about for two debates. Fear. ISIS is going to kill us if we don't elect a president, a Republican president. Because that's all they have. All they have is fear. They can't talk about the economy. They can't talk about healthcare. They can't talk about racial relations by any means. So it's just fear. Let's elect a Republican so that we don't all die.